top priorities at University Hospital Birmingham is to reduce and prevent the spread of infection. Our staff take this very seriously. Our aim is to reduce MRSA, Clostridium difficile and other infections, and we need our patients and visitors to help us. Everyone has a part to play in preventing the spread of infection, not just nurses and doctors, but patients, relatives and visitors. Visitors can play a huge part in reducing spread of infection and make a huge difference by following a few simple steps. Remember, good hand hygiene is the most effective method of reducing the spread of infection. When visiting any ward or department, you will be asked to clean your hands on entering and leaving the area. You will also be asked to clean your hands before and after touching patients. This will involve either the use of soap and water or an alcohol gel. But don't worry, the staff will remind you about the most appropriate way to carry this out.
All hospitals have hand gel to clean your hands with, but these gels, whilst they're effective against bacteria such as MRSA, don't work against C. difficile. Therefore, it's important before and after every patient contact to wash your hands thoroughly with soap and water. Washing your hands is a 7-stage procedure, and here's how to do it.
I'm going to show you the correct way to wash your hands. You need to turn the taps on first so you've got running water. Wet your hands thoroughly and then apply some soap. A good lather. Hands palm to palm first, and then palm washing the back of the opposite hand. Interlace your fingers to make sure that the fingers are clean in between, and then using the backs of your fingers, wash the palms of your hands. Then include the thumbs with some rotational rubbing, and the wrists. Try to do 5 movements of each, and then rinse off the soap under running water. Turn off the taps without touching them with your hands, and a good dry with paper towels.
We have these hand gels in all clinical areas such as wards and treatment rooms. The gels are available either outside the areas or within the areas themselves. It's important to remember that these gels are active against bacteria such as MRSA, but don't kill C. difficile, so it's important before and after every patient contact to wash your hands with soap and water. The way to use the gel is a 7-stage procedure, and here's how to do it.
The alcohol gel is freely available around the hospital. The technique for applying is the same as with hand washing, so make sure that you've covered all areas of your hands, in between the fingers, thumbs and wrists. Exactly the same as with the hand washing. No need to dry separately. Once it's rubbed into your skin, that's it.
It's really important because we all see lots of patients every day, and we're definitely a vector for infection. And the more patients we see, you know, the better the greater risk of infection, really. So we have to wash our hands between every patient, and that's essential, really.
It's very important to clean your hands so that we don't pass on our germs to patients. We don't receive their germs, and to stop cross-infection. This should be done before entering a ward and when leaving a ward.
Well, hand hygiene is very important. It helps to stop infections and the germs. And especially when going onto the ward, you should always wash your hands before going onto the ward and when leaving the ward.
As a cancer specialist, I'm very aware that my patients have often got low white blood cell counts as a result of either their chemotherapy or radiotherapy, and are therefore particularly vulnerable to infections. Any patient that we have in the ward is often very sick, and again, that makes them vulnerable as well. So clearly hospitals are full of potentially very resistant organisms, and spreading them from one patient to another is clearly represents a big hazard to the patients, and not transferring them on your hands clearly improves the safety of the patients.
Well, everyone in a hospital environment should be aware of good hand hygiene. Visitors to a ward, anyone that is entering or leaving a ward should wash their hands or use the hand gel. And this is especially important if we come into contact with patients.
It's very, very important, and it could also save a life.